making a hollow impact-resistant casting using the SmoothCast 65D and Urofill 11. Now, my main objective for this project is to create a lightweight casting that is very impact-resistant while using the least amount of resin. This will result in material and cost savings over a solid casting. For this project, I've decided to use the SmoothCast 65D, which cures gradually versus a snap cure. It also has a fast pot life of 2.5 minutes. I'm going to use the Urofill 11 fiber-based filler that is going to thicken up our resin and help us achieve the final casting thickness in only 4 layers. Keep in mind that using a wrong product for this type of project can result in a failed casting and, of course, wasted material. Here you can see me hollow casting a product that had a snap cure and set up as soon as the pot life had expired, resulting in a lot of wasted product. Instead, what we're looking for is a material that cures gradually versus a snap cure, and it's going to allow us to slush it around inside our mold while it's slowly setting up. I'm using a MoldMax stroke mold that has a cut seam. This is an area where the resin could leak out off our mold and bond to the support shell. And to prevent this, I'm simply going to apply some sonite wax to the inside and the flange of our shell. The two halves are now fitted back together and are bolted using some wing nut screws. Now, I like to use these because they are very easy to remove and don't put unnecessary stress on the support shell. This resin has an easy to use 1-to-1 mix ratio by volume, so I'm simply going to mark my dispensing cups and proceed to pre-mix the two components. I'm going to start by dispensing and pre-tinting the Part B with some So Strong Black. The SmoothCast 65D cures bright white, but a little bit of So Strong Black will turn our casting a soft gray. The reason why I waited to dispense the Part A is because it is very sensitive to atmospheric moisture and I don't want to risk any contamination issues. Now I can simply pour the resin into the mold, and while visually inspecting, I'm going to rotate the mold and spill some of that resin right over the edge. This is going to help me build up the resin thickness all along the perimeter of our casting. Here you can see why it's important to put some of that sonite wax on the support shell edges. The mold is rotated until the pot life has fully expired, which should be about 2.5 minutes. Now we can set the mold aside and let the material partially cure for about 5 minutes before applying the next layer. The second layer is dispensed, tinted, and pre-mixed the same way that the first layer. We can then proceed to pour the resin into the mold. And here you can see that I'm actually making sure I'm pouring the resin right over the high points to get a layer of resin onto them. And just like we did in the first layer, we're going to bring the resin right up to the edge and spill some of it to make sure that we get a nice and even casting thickness all the way throughout. Continue to rotate your mold in a 360-degree pattern until the pot life has fully expired. Now, for the third layer, we're going to step up the amount of resin that we're dispensing. And just like we did previously, we're going to tint and premix the Part B using some So Strong, and then proceed to dispense the same amount of Urofill 11 by volume. I find that an even amount of Urofill 11 to the Part B results in a creamy consistency that is liquid enough to be slushed inside the mold. We can then proceed to dispensing the Part A and mixing the three components well together. And here you can see I'm bringing it right over the edge to make sure that the edges are the same thickness as the rest of our casting. Now I'm going to set the mold upside down before the resin has fully set up, and the reason for doing so is I'm allowing the resin to make its way down and out of the mold to control some of that thickness off the edge. The resin is allowed a partial cure for about 5 minutes before dispensing the final layer. Now the final layer we're going to mix the same way that we did the third layer by adding the Urofill 11 and rotate the mold in a 360-degree pattern until the material has partially set up. And then we're going to set it upside down to allow any of the unset resin to make its way slowly down and out of our mold. Again, this is going to be very helpful to controlling that casting thickness. Our casting is now allowed a full cure for about 1 hour. While the resin could technically speaking be demolded sooner, I like to give it some extra curing time because resins, when cast in thin sections, usually takes a little bit longer for them to fully set up. Now here you can see the benefit of applying of the sonite wax to the support shell. Any leaked resin is simply peeled away and will not stick. Our silicone mold can now simply be peeled away to reveal a fully detailed casting. Any of the resin flashing can be simply be grinded down using a Dremel tool to a desired seam line. The casting edges should be about 1/4 inch thickness to ensure a good and strong casting. A quick hand inspection shows me that I've achieved a uniform casting thickness throughout the entire piece. Now to test how well the casting is going to hold up to the everyday use, I'm going to simply drop it down the staircase and see how well it does. And after numerous impacts, our final casting shows no visual damage. So there you have it, a simple and inexpensive way to create a hollow impact-resistant casting using the SmoothCast 65D and Urofill 11. Now, if you would like to purchase any of the products that we use in this video, you can do so by visiting any one of our distributors around the world. Now, if you have an idea about what we should mold next, let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like to see more videos like this, please hit the thumbs up button. And to keep up with our latest mold making and casting videos, remember to subscribe.